morning class. I am Purnima and I am going to welcome you all in my class. And student, I am going to start a new topic with you today, that is advertisement. I hope everybody know what is an advertisement. But what is an advertisement in a proper manner, this I am going to teach you today. Okay, till now you must be thinking advertisements are some of the television ads or ads in the newspaper. This is simply an advertisement. No. Children, it is a part of advertisement which we see. But how we write it, how we note each and everything, how what type of language should be written to make advertisement more attractive, then how many types of advertisements are there, and it is the most so powerful source to influence the minds of the people. So children, this is advertisement, and now I'm going to tell you that how many types of advertisement. First of all children, what is an advertisement? Advertisement is a very powerful medium. What is an advertisement? It is a very powerful medium, and children, it influences the mind of the people. It influences the mind of the people and it motivates the masses. Okay, it motivates the masses, and it is an announcement made through a popular medium. It is an announcement made through the popular medium, and children, which attract the maximum number of people. So that medium can be anything. Okay, like children, newspaper, magazine, then television, radio, internet, and of course we cannot forget cinema. Cinema is also playing an important source to bring this advertisement to the mass of people. Okay, so there are many sources to influence the mind of the people, and like newspaper, television, cinema, magazines. Okay, these are the various sources. And children, there are very many social institutes are also there which is used to pass the advertisement in a for various purpose. Okay, so children, this is the advertisement. This is actually the advertisement is that it influences the mind of the people. Okay, the best advertisement can influence maximum mind of the people. So now children, I will be telling you how many types of advertisements are there. So advertisements are of two types, as I've written on the board. One is classified and the other is general display advertisement. So here I'm telling you about what is there in your syllabus is about two types of advertisement. One is classified and other is general display advertisement. Okay, now children, classified advertisement are mostly, it is very much similar to like notices. Notice writing we have done. So classified advertisement are very much similar to notices. They differ only in content. So what is the difference between notice and advertisement? This I will be telling you in detail, but they differ in content. Content of the notice is something else, and contents of the advertisement is something else. Okay. Now children, advertisement generally attract the immediate attention of a large number of people. And children, sometimes they are printed, and children, sometimes like in the TV you can see it is not printed. Okay, a small video is there to attack the people. And children, now I am going to tell you what is the difference between a notice and an advertisement. What is the difference between a notice and an advertisement? So as I told you, advertisement are of two different types, classified advertisement and general display advertisement. It is a source which influences the mind of the people. It attracts a lot of people. A good advertisement can attract maximum number of people. Okay, and advertisement are of various type, and that I will be telling you that how to draft advertisement of various thing. Okay, I also told you that classified advertisement are very much like notice. Classified advertisement are very much like notice. Only the content of notice and advertisement are a bit different from each other. Now children, first of all, I would like to share to you the difference between notice and advertisement. So children, an advertisement is basically, it is commercial or matrimonial. So what is advertisement? It is mostly commercial, that means maximum people have to be attracted through it, and it is matrimonial. Okay, like children, situation vacant. Okay, situation vacant is, in one of the video I told you about job application. So situation vacant means if there is job, advertisement is there, so that is conveyed to the people through situation vacant. That means if a vacancy is there, so that vacancy you know from the classified or commercial advertisement. Okay, or to let in the newspaper. What is the meaning of children? To let, that means children, if you wanted to give some shop, okay, people hire the shop, they pay a heavy rent in the mall, so for that type of notices you have to write to let. If you are having enough space and you think it can be used, it is in the commercial place and you think it can be used for the office, so children, you post an advertisement in the newspaper and the heading should be to let, and then you have to write, children, that I've got this much size room or space which can be used for office purposes. Okay, and then other facilities which you are having in that place, like drinking facility, water drinking facilities there, then washroom facilities is there, so all the facility which is there, parking facilities is there for the people, it is on the main road, so many facility you can write in that to let advertisement. Children, a notice generally is information. Okay, and it is given to a section of people, not to all the people. Like children, if advertisement of to let is there, it is for maximum number of people they can see. But children, in notices, if a notice or something, some important information is there, it is only for some selective people. Okay, so suppose if notice is there related with examination, so only it is benefited to students. Okay, or if children, program is there in the club, so only some people who are related with club, only those people are benefited. So this is a great difference between a notice and an advertisement. Through advertisement many people are informed, but notice, children, is only for informing some small section of people. Now children, advertisement in the form of a catchy phrases, that means whatever you are writing the words, okay, it should attract the people. So children, advertisement can be in the form of catchy phrases, half sentences and even slogan, not full sentence, because children, nowadays nobody have time to read that long advertisement. So it can be half sentence, half an attractive sentence, and even slogans or thought. Now a notice give a formal announcement. What does a notice give? A formal announcement or information in complete sense. But children, advertisement pass the information in half a sentence or in slogans. So and children, its tone and style is formal and factual. Okay, so this was the major difference between notice and advertisement. Now children, the main thing is that how to draft an advertisement, how you have to write an advertisement. Now this is very important, and I'm going to give you some useful tips and so that you can write it. Okay, so children, like for example, I am going to take here business advertisement. There are many types of advertisement are there, commercial advertisement, okay, advertisement related with business. So here I am going to take the business advertisement. Its main aim is the promotion of sale. Okay, what is the main aim of business advertisement? Its main aim is to promote the sale of the product. You should draft children only an advertisement that may tempt the readers to go through it. Children, that means that your drafting of the advertisement should be done in such a way that the reader or the person who reads it, he or she should be tempted by it. Tempted means he should be attracted, he should be curious. Oh, is this the shampoo? Oh, I will try. So many best benefits are written here. Shiny hair. Okay. The cost is also very, is okay. Okay, not very expensive. It is a herbal product. Okay. What are the things which are good for hair, like amlas are there, and Rita. Okay, all that things are there in that product. Okay. So children, this type of advertisement is to promote the growth of sale. Okay. So the reader should be tempted. Tempted means they should not ignore the advertisement. They should be attracted. They should read that what is there written in the advertisement to promote the growth. Interesting and meaningful advertisement. Children, interesting and meaningful advertisement always attract the great mass of the people. Well, children, my second point for drafting a notice is to use a catchy, simple and effective language. So children, you have to use simple, okay, catchy and attractive or effective language. Your notice your advertisement should be very simple. That means even the layman type of people, they also read the see the advertisement. They should know that what this advertisement is about. It should not be written in a very difficult words. Meaning should be there, difficult words should be there, new words should be there, so people will find hard to understand. And children, it should have an effective language. The people should enjoy reading that language. Okay. I know children, there are many advertisements like Parle biscuit advertisements is there. Okay, there are many Bonvita advertisements are there. So small videos are there, so it attracts a lot of people. Alright. Then children, many people are even taking the help of Bollywood stars and sports stars. So it attracts a lot of people. So that it attracts a lot of people. And in this way, manner, they make their advertisement very effective. Now children, there should be happy blending of content and style. Nothing negative should be written in the advertisement. This is the main thing. Or everything should be written in a positive manner, okay, in a good manner, sometimes in a funny manner also we can say. Okay, so this is the style of a good advertisement. The content should be written not in a negative manner. And children, the other thing, it should state the fact. It should state whatever the fact is there in the advertisement, it should be stated in the clear manner. Okay. The advertisement should be brief and to the point. Okay. The advertisement should be brief and to the point. Alright, so very large an advertisement should not be there. Now student, the fifth point related with advertisement is that children, advertisement should not be written in a lengthy manner. That means that whatever sentence you are choosing, it should not be lengthy, it should not be dull, it should not be made heavy. Okay. Because children, nobody have time to read dull and lengthy advertisement. children. That's why nowadays the advertisement people are focusing on making advertisement or a small two verses song or a poem. Okay, that means in a verse form, so that people don't have time to read, so that at least they can listen those advertisement. So it should not be heavy, lengthy and dull. To attract the eyes of the reader, we can use children different types of letters or of different size. Children, when you must have seen, there are many advertisement of are there on the road. Like children, one is my favorite, Amul butter. Okay, so you can see the nice wording is written, Amul doodh peeta hai in India, all this thing. So these are catchy slogans are there, okay, and it attracts, and sometimes children, it makes us smile also. Some nice words are written that we smile also when we read or hear such type of advertisement. Okay, so there you can use different sizes of letter also, and different styles of letter you can use to make your advertisement attractive. So then children, one more thing, that in this age, in this era where the people don't have time or patience to go through lengthy and dull write-ups, so children, very short slogans should be written, okay? And as soon as the people read the slogan, they should know what are the qualities of that product, okay? Then the name of the advertiser. This is also an important point. The name of the advertiser and the advertised product should be given in bold or capital letters in general or display advertisement. So children, what is the name of the advertiser and the advertised product should be given in bold or capital letter in general. Students are advised to read classified advertisement columns and commercial advertisement of a leading newspaper. Now children, being a student and you have to write, children, so many type of advertisement can come in the examination. So children, it is advised to you that try to read different type of, whenever you are free, you just throw a glance on the newspaper or some of the magazine which is there in your house and see how nicely the advertisement, what type of words are there quoted in those advertisement. Okay, have a time for yourself for a few minutes and try to read. Children, the more you will read, the maximum what you will grasp in your mind, so that you can also write a good advertisement. Okay, and situation, vacant, matrimonial, all these type of advertisements are always there in front of you, especially in the Sunday newspaper. Okay, the tone and the mood and the style of advertisement should be matched with its subject. Children, you should be very particular what this advertisement is about, and then you should choose some slogans according to it. Okay, so children, these are some of the qualities to write a to draft a advertisement. Okay, now children, I told you that we are having two types of advertisement, classified advertisement and general display advertisement. Now some feature of classified advertisement I am going to tell to you. Okay children, first of all, classy advertisement, children, it should have only word limit of 50 words. It should have word limit of how many words? 50 words. Children, and the important point when you will write classy advertisement is that it should be relevant. That means no extra thing, because your word limit is fixed. Okay, so you cannot write any irrelevant thing. Only to the point things, and children, it should be short and to the point. Because children, the main thing is that when you go for the advertisement in the newspaper, they charge the money for each and every word. This is also the point. if you want to first of all you have to manage a good advertisement. If you want to sell your products, okay, or children, if you are a teacher, you want to post a student. So children, some selective word you have to choose. Catchy slogan should be there, nice phrases should be there, okay. You can write in the words form, all right. So for that, what you have to do, children, you have to choose selective word, because your notice cannot be more than 50 words. And children, when you will go to the newspaper and tell them to print your advertisement, they will charge per word, it is charged, okay. So the more short the advertisement, your advertisement will be, the less money it will cost, okay. Now, and classified advertisement, no blocks or design in also, it should not be used there. And children, as I told you, your language should be simple, brief, factual and formal, okay. So these are the some of the important point of a classified advertisement. Now children, I am going to read one question which came in the Central Board of Secondary School examination, okay, related with your advertisement, and I am going to draw one advertisement for you. So let's read. Wanted a receptionist for Sunrise Global School. So children, you have to write an advertisement related with situation vacant. Okay, what you have to write an advertisement? You have to write an advertisement related with situation vacant. So I am going to read a question which came in the examination of CBSE, and that question we can discuss here. So children, the question is, principal, Sunrise Global School, Agra, requires a receptionist for her school. Now children, a receptionist is required. Children, in our school, so many people are there which plays an important role. We don't feel, we don't see in front of them, but they really play an important role, like librarian, lab assistant, receptionist. So they do play an important role in the school. So what is the situation vacant is for? It is situation vacant is for the post of a receptionist. So let's read the question once again. Principal, Sunrise Global School, Agra, requires a receptionist for her school. Draft a suitable advertisement in about 50 words to be published in the classified column of a national newspaper. So where it should be published? In the classified column of a national newspaper. Children, remember, this is a national newspaper. If it would have been local newspaper, then children, there are two type of newspaper. I told you in the letter writing also. One is national level newspaper like the Hindu, the Times of India, the Hindustan Times, the Panier, and one is the local newspaper like in Varanasi we have Dainik Jagran, Hindustan, the Times of India. Okay, there are many local newspapers are also there in our city. And suppose in Rajasthan we have Rajasthan Patrika. Okay, every city, every state, they have their local newspaper also. So here it is written, which newspaper? In the national newspaper, giving all the necessary details of qualification. And children, you have to, whenever that you have to answer, you have to give the necessary details of qualification and experience, okay, required in the receptionist. So children, this you have to write, okay. This is the advertisement of situation vacant. So how you are going to start, children? You are going to start. So student, I have read the question. What is the question is about? The principal is advertisement in the newspaper. And the topic should be situation vacant. That means she is asking for a receptionist to apply for a job in her school. Okay. So, so you have to draft the advertisement. So children, how you will draft the advertisement? First, you will be writing situation vacant, because this is a job, the advertisement related with a job appearance for the job applicants people. So here you have to write situation vacant, right? and children, then you have to write first thing, children, first line you should write what this advertisement is about. So this advertisement is about that the principal wanted a receptionist in her school. So how you are going to start, you can write, children, my very first sentence is beginning with the word wanted is receptionist for Sunrise Global School. That means as soon as the people, the advertisement which you are going to make, and the person is going to read the advertisement, at that very moment he will know that particular school wanted a receptionist. Okay, so wanted a receptionist for Sunrise Global School, Agra. Now, children, a receptionist should have a pleasant personality and good communication skill. So that you have to mention, a young and attractive outgoing personality with pleasant manner. Okay, a graduate with good communication skill. Of course, children, the educational qualification is a must. So what is the minimum qualification he or she should have? He or she should be graduate. Should have effective communication skill. Basic computer literacy is essential. Children, nowadays is the age of computer. Okay, so basic computer literacy is essential. Experience in a prestigious educational institution will be an added consideration. Children, the preference will be given to the experienced person who has worked in a prestigious educational institution. Emoluments, no bar to the deserving candidate. Apply within a week with all necessary documents. The week time is also there. Okay, with all the necessary document of the mark sheet and other children degree, other extra activity if she or he is involved, at everything document it is wanted in the school. Principal Sunrise Global School, Agra. And children, in the last, what you will write, that who is the person who has advertised this notice. So it is the principal Sunrise Global School, Agra. And then, children, you have to write the mobile number also. Okay. So this is the thing. Now, children, one more notice of situation vacant, I am going to discuss it. You are Peach Sharma of Varanasi. You are a person whose name is Peach Sharma. That person is living in Varanasi. You want an English tutor for your daughter. You wanted an English tutor to teach his daughter. Okay. Write out an advertisement to be published in the classified columns of a local newspaper. So what you have to write? You have to write an advertisement that you want a good tutor, English tutor for your daughter, and he or she can come and teach your daughter. So children, how you will write? In the beginning, the always start first line that what your advertisement is about. So children, your advertisement is about an English teacher. So in the very first line, like children, here I've written wanted a receptionist. You can also start with in the very first line, you can write wanted an English tutor for a girl of class 12. Okay, wanted an English tutor for a girl of class 12. Only children, then some other things you can apply, like only ladies with a minimum experience of teaching 10 to 2 classes for 5 years. At least the teacher he wanted, he should have 5 years experience, and that teacher should be a lady teacher. Okay. Emulation. Now children, emulation, what are the emulation you he or she is going to get? Traveling expenses plus 4,500 to 5, children, traveling expenses. Okay, so first thing, the teacher may get traveling expenses. Okay, and children, the timing is also told in the emulation, that the timing will be between 4 p.m. to 5 p.m. And then children, contact. Okay, contact number. Mr. P. Sharma, 120L Civil Line, Varanasi. And of course, children, nowadays, children, nobody has so much time to go and visit the place. So, phone number or the mobile number is must. So, you have to, at the last, you have to write the mobile number. Okay. So, in this way, children, if this is the advertisement, you can see, so in a simple language, you can come to know that this advertisement is about what. And children, the contact number, the mobile number of Mr. Sharma can also be seen here. So easily you can contact. Then the other emulation like traveling allowance and the timing for the teacher to come. Okay. And also children, you can write the salary also. Or if you don't write, then also it is doesn't matter. Okay. So all this thing, all the proper information should be given in the advertisement of situation vacant. In my next video, I will be telling you about other advertisement also. This is all for today. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.